Yes. What's your interests anyway in coming here and having a look at this house?
Prior to that, they built British buildings in Darwin, which of course were pizza ovens.
Which one? Where are those?
There's still some of them. Yes, I'll show you. There's still some of them. But they were constantly moved in several different ways. They were British style, so they had big stone doors, small windows, no overhang on the roofs.
So people from overseas always get the top jobs, don't they, in Australia? So these people were Britishers who wanted a British type house. So Burnett knew that if you designed a tropical house, it should only be one room wide. But of course these people wanted rooms. They wanted to put an internal wall across your airflow. So what he did was he took the ceiling up as high as he possibly could, get the hot air out, and he didn't take the walls up there. See, he doesn't take them up to the ceiling at all. He also blocked the airflow off. So he's got airflow up there, he's got airflow down here, which is terrible. And he's put a vent in the ceiling there to get the hot air out of these rooms and up into the roof space. And he's put a vent along the ridge of the roof to get the hot air out of the roof space. And he's got open eaves, so the hot air is flowing from the eaves and through the roof. And it's drawing the air out of the space. So that's what he did here. These are not bedrooms, they're dressing rooms. He doesn't expect you to be silly enough to sleep in. Although one of our National Trust members actually did sleep in this room in the 1970s when he was a young public servant. Where you do sleep is out. It gives you an ordinary British type window, which is an ordinary Australian type window too, because we're all prisoners by heart. And an ordinary British window is ordinary British window only will attract airflow. You might get a breeze through it if it blows against the wall. And the sill makes sure that if you're sitting down or if you're lying down, you're not going to get any breeze at all. That's because the British abhor a draft. They don't want drafts because you die often in Britain. You get a chill from a draft. But of course, in the tropics, you'd give your right arm for a draft. So, Burnett opens the wall into the corner of the house. It doesn't matter which direction the air blows past the house, it will draw air through the house. And you can stand here. There's no breeze at the present moment, but you can stand there and feel the airflow on your hands. That was completely ignored after the war, when Burnett no longer worked for them. So all the houses they built after the war didn't work. And they built hundreds of them in Darwin. They were hot. The other thing was they had high-pitched roof. And the third thing is, the closest you approximate to an equilateral triangle, the closest you approximate to the strongest geometrical shape we have in engineering. So a high-pitched roof is stronger
than a flat roof or a low pitched roof. It's also disruptive to the airflow, and so in a cyclone it stays on, whereas a low pitched roof or a flat roof imitates the action of an aeroplane wing and flies away. And so these houses kept their roofs during Cyclone Tracy and are still here. The rest of Darwin blew away.
Still the original.
He was honest enough to say, I'll do it for 420,000. And he did it for 420,000. Right? And then 2 years after that, he told me, because I had him round to dinner to say thank you for building my house. And 2 years later, I said to him, you know, thanks for doing that. And he said, yes, well, he said, I did quite well out of that.